The inductor, also called the choke or a reactor, is similar to the transformer by design and can also have a conventional or toroid layout. But unlike a transformer, the inductor has only one winding and only two terminals. The inductor, just like a capacitor, can store energy. However, it releases all energy immediately after the supply voltage is removed, unlike the capacitor, which can store it for a relatively long time. You can observe the operation of a choke with the help of two simple experiments. Here you can see a light bulb, a choke, and a battery. Let us connect all these elements in series. As we can see, when the bulb is wired through a choke, it does not light up instantly, but with some delay. This is because the moment the circuit is closed, part of the energy is stored in the magnetic circuit of the choke, that is, it's being charged. When the core of the choke is saturated, energy begins to flow into the load. Now let us wire the bulb and the choke in parallel. The bulb also turns on with a slight delay, but that is because the very first moment the choke imposes load on the battery. A more interesting effect is observed when the battery is disconnected. We can see that the bulb does not go out instantly, but gives an additional flash. This happens because once the supply voltage is removed, the inductor transfers the energy stored in its core to the bulb. Now let us modify the circuit a bit. It is known that the voltage spike that occurs on inductor's terminals, again unlike in a capacitor, has a reverse polarity. So, if we connect a diode in series with the bulb, we will have a chance to observe the process of choke discharging separately. Now the bulb flashes only when the power is turned off.